Hey guys, today we're going to show you how to correctly fill and bleed a power steering system. Let's go. When you're replacing a steering component, it's really important to make sure you bleed all of the air out of the system. So let's get started. First, raise the wheels of the vehicle off the ground and support the vehicle with jack stands. Fill the reservoir to the cold line with an OE-approved power steering fluid, and with the engine not running, turn the steering wheel lock to lock 10 to 15 times. This will normally purge most of the air from the system. Check and refill fluid as necessary, then start the engine, and again, turn the steering wheel lock to lock 10 to 15 times. Check and refill fluid as necessary. All air should now be bled out of the system. Some vehicles are more difficult to bleed than others. If you can't seem to get all of the air out of the system, noticing that the pump is still noisy or fluid spews out of the reservoir when the engine is shut off, a vacuum bleed should get the job done. Ensure that the fluid is filled to the cold line and take a vacuum pump such as this and apply 15 to 18 inches of vacuum to the reservoir. You can modify an old power steering cap by drilling a hole and installing a fitting that will connect up to your vacuum pump, or some guys just use a tapered rubber stopper with a fitting to do the job. Keeping the reservoir under this vacuum and cycling the steering wheel left and right for 5 minutes with the engine running should be enough to purge the remaining air out of the system. You'll notice the fluid level may have dropped as you displaced an air pocket. Recheck and top off the reservoir. And one other important thing to remember, never use engine vacuum as your source of vacuum. You can seriously damage the engine. That's all for now. I hope this information has been helpful. Thank you for your time, and I'll see you on our next edition of ProTech.